Hi! This could be the dawn of a new era for me. After making over 50 videos since 2009 about magnets and magnetism using permanent magnets, I will test my first electromagnet in this video. Will a fan of neodymium magnets like me be impressed or disappointed by the force of an electromagnet? Where are the poles and highest magnetic field strength on this thing? And can I overclock it for more power? Let's find out! Be careful near strong magnets. Don't let them bite your fingers. An electromagnet is a simple device. You can build your own with a bolt, some insulated wire, and a battery. Just wrap the wire as a coil around the bolt and you have an electromagnet. Without electricity, it is not a magnet, but when you add a battery, it is sort of a magnet. Not an impressive pull force when being used to handling neodymium magnets. Measured on a research lab grade Tesla meter, it is around 60 Gauss max, or around 120 times the Earth's magnetic field at my place. Weak. But I'll get back to this magnet later in the video. Let's switch to my first commercial electromagnet. A 12 volts, 11 watts, 50 by 30 millimeter version, and hopefully stronger than my home build. I will run this with my first lab power supply. Here's how I set it all up. Alright, time to turn it on. I'll dial up the current to max and let the power supply and Ohm's law decide how much current the electromagnet receives. Wait a minute, that's 8 watts, not 11. Is my basic power supply sketchy? Let me double check the readings. Voltage and amperage seem legit. The third piece of the puzzle in Ohm's law is ohms. If the seller's website is right, the resistance is 13 ohms. If the power supply is right, the resistance is 18 ohms. Who's right? At 24 degrees C, the resistance is 18 ohms. Okay. After digging a little deeper, sure enough, it is an 8 watt magnet. The power supply is right. What really matters is, does the magnet work? Oh yes. Considering how little of the magnet's pole surface is used, this is not bad at all. And compared to neodymium magnets, it is so convenient to just turn the magnet on and off as needed, and with no risk of chipping the magnet like the brittle neomagnets. Though I do recommend using a UPS for the power supply. A power outage at this moment would leave marks. Not only can the magnet be turned on and off, it also has variable strength. Check this out. To no one's surprise, it gets stronger the more power you put into it. However, doubling the wattage does not double the magnetic force. It's more like quadruple the wattage to double the Gauss. That causes an issue, more about it later. But is the center the strongest point? Let's sweep across the surface. Where the white line is highest, the magnetic field is the strongest. Okay, this inner edge is the strongest part of the magnet. I found its max to be around 1.5 kilogauss. The centerpiece is the south pole, making the outer ring of this potted magnet the north pole with a lower field strength due to a larger diameter. Actually, you can change the electromagnet's polarity by simply changing the electrical polarity. And by easily bridging the two poles, you can increase the pull force. Now I measure 2.3 kilogauss on the edge of the center pole, around 4,600 times the Earth's magnetic field. Sounds impressive, but how does it compare to a neodymium magnet? I don't have a 50 by 30 millimeters neo magnet. This one is the closest in size in my collection. Its volume is 10% larger, but its grade is a mediocre N40, so not an unreasonable comparison. Starting at the center, we are already above 4 kilogauss, not looking good for the electromagnet. Once again, the edge is the strongest. Max is above 7.6 kilogauss, even without bridged poles. Yeah, for raw pull force per volume, neodymium magnets win big. But what will happen if I overclock the electromagnet? Can it handle a little more power? After a short message, I will test it. I'll even give my home-built electromagnet a second chance. A big, big thanks to all my patrons. Thank you so much for helping out. It's really appreciated and important for a niche channel with monthly quality uploads like mine. For just a dollar a month, you can help me out too and get full access to all my posts on patreon.com. Link to my Patreon page in the description. Thank you. I was not fair to my home-built electromagnet in the first test. Feeding it with only 1.5 volts at a resistance of 14.6 ohms. It was a 0.15 watt magnet. No wonder its performance was subpar. What if I used 12 volts instead? Much better. Running at 10 watts, it is now a proper electromagnet. If I potted it and used a core of a soft magnetic material instead of a bolt, it would be even better, like they did with the commercial magnet. Time to be a little naughty and overclock this beyond its spec. What happens at 14 volts instead of the nominal 12 volts? At 10.5 watts, the unbridged max kilogauss increases to 1.666, roughly 15% more from 30% more watts. And running it at 14.5 volts, as the 11 watt electromagnet I thought I bought, its center gauss increases similarly by roughly 20% from 40% more wattage. So yeah, you can overclock it. There's just one problem. You can't feel it from the video, but I notice the electromagnet heats up during use. The more power, the faster it heats up. And the hotter it gets, the higher the resistance, making the magnet lose power. Here's the result from a 30 minutes test running it with Inspex. Looks like there is a delay before the heat from the coil reached the backplate, but after half an hour, it is an unpleasant 60 degrees C hot. It lost 18% power and therefore roughly 9% strength based on previous tests, just from the heat. Neodymium magnets don't heat up themselves like this. 60 degrees C is not a problem for the electromagnet itself. It is rated for scorching 130 degrees C, but overclocking will increase the heating rate and cause overheating. Makes me wonder how much I can safely overclock it if I cool the magnet with, say, an all-in-one water cooler for a PC. Make sure you are subscribed if you want to see that. Alright, how do I sum up my first experiences with a commercial electromagnet? The pull force per volume is not impressive compared to neodymium magnets. I don't like that it heats up, lowers its pull force when in use, and you have to trust a power supply. However, I absolutely love the ability to turn it off and even easily vary the pull force and polarity. That is so much more convenient, safe and flexible than a permanent neomagnet. I will definitely experiment more with electromagnets. Click like if you want to see more videos on it and comment if you have a test you would like to see. I think I will try to go bigger in the future. I mean, my lab power supply will deliver up to 300 watts. In any case, thanks for watching. Bye for now.